Hi Virgo, welcome to your daily love reading. My name is Pretty and I'll be doing your love reading today. So before you begin with your love reading, Virgo, please do remember to take what resonates and to leave behind whatever does not. Okay, so let's begin with your love reading, Virgo. Okay, so at the bottom of the deck, we have the Queen of Cups. So this is water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. You could be dealing with any of these signs. So this is an energy of really being in your divine feminine mode. This is a nurturing, intuitive energy. Someone may be seeing you in this light or appreciating you for these qualities. The side of your personality, you know, you're showing up as a nurturer, a very kind-hearted and compassionate person, very empathic as well. So you may be, your intuition may be very heightened at this time as well. So it would behoove you to really listen to your emotions and your feelings as well. I do see you being guided a lot by those energies, your feelings, emotions, your intuition, you know, those divine feminine qualities of you. I do see them guiding you in a situation right now. You're showing up as having a lot of love to offer as well. So I do see that you are giving and receiving a lot of love and compassion here. So let's see what the rest of the cards have to say about this, Virgo. So the first card we have here is the Ten of Wands. So this is fire energy, Sagittarius, Aries, Leo energy. Next we have the Temperance. This is Sagittarius energy. And finally, we have the Star card. So this is Aquarius energy. Okay, so there is an energy here of you having a lot of love to give here with this Queen of Cups energy. I see you stepping out of this Ten of Wands energy. If you were pursuing someone or if you were taking action in a situation, I see you stepping back from that and instead of pursuing, you're attracting now. There is an energy of you letting things come to you. This is very divine energy. This Temperance is also practicing alchemy as well. So things are changing in a situation. So one way that you were doing things before, I see you switching it up. This is it, the Ten of Wands. This is closing something, you know, realizing that something isn't working, and that it's actually becoming more draining than anything, and you are changing your approach to something is what I'm seeing here. And with the Star card again, that is you attracting, you manifesting something, some wish fulfillment here for you. And I do see your patience as well. You're in this energy of, you know, spiritual energy, you know, a divine energy of knowing that when something, you can feel something is about to happen. And I do see that there is love here, and things are about to really happen for you without you having to go out and make it happen. With the Ten of Wands, this is you dropping a burden. You may have been overexerting yourself in a situation, and you may have found that it wasn't working for you. And once you drop this burden, you find that suddenly you're able to just attract things instead of always having to exert, you know, overdo the masculine side of taking action. So I do see you stepping into this Queen of Cups energy and really attracting whatever it is that you want. So I am seeing that what you want wants you. It's finally coming towards you. You don't have to go after it. So let's clarify these cards. Okay, so at the bottom of the deck, we have the Three of Swords in the reverse. So this is air energy, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. You could have been dealing with any of these signs. So the Three of Swords in the reverse is a card of coming out of heartbreak. This is you realizing that some approach is leading to more pain than it is to fulfillment. So even with that Ten of Wands, this is a completion energy. You're changing your approach to something. And I do see that there is some pain that still lingers with the Three of Swords energy here. But because it's in the reverse, this is something you're overcoming. This is you finally healing and, you know, trying to, you know, heal these wounds. These wounds are still there. There's still a bit of a reminder of the past and the past baggage, the emotional baggage of the past that still lingers around you. I do see that you've learned a lot of lessons from this and you're on a healing journey as well. There is a lot of healing energy here. And I do see that this Three of Swords thing is something that you're overcoming here now. With it being in the reverse, this is, you know, moving forward slowly but surely. You're coming out of this pain energy here. So let's see what the rest of the cards have to say about this. So next we have the Five of Wands. So this is fire energy, Sagittarius, Aries, Leo energy. And next we have the Ace of Cups again. This is water energy, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. And finally we have the Ten of Wands for a second time. This is fire energy, Sagittarius, Aries, Leo energy. Okay, so there is that energy here of nearing the end of a journey. This may have been a lot of a very emotionally conflictual situation for you. There may have been a lot of competition. You may have felt like you had to prove your worth, prove yourself to someone. And this led to more pain than it did to fulfillment. And I do see that you're not competing for anyone's love. So there is an energy here of you not chasing. Instead, you're attracting. And you are attracting this abundance, this fulfillment with this Ace of Cups. This is emotional fulfillment. This is you getting what you want. This is a lot of love, heartfelt energy. And I do see that it's coming towards you. And you're showing up as this queen of cups. This is you mastering your emotions. And no one can use your emotions against you anymore. You've healed a lot. So with this Three of Swords energy, it's possible that in the past there was some someone may have tried to take advantage of you, made you have to prove yourself, you know, fight or compete for their affection. But now I see that you've removed yourself from that, you know, and this has really elevated your position. Now you are being held up higher, you know, because this person is realizing that you're not going to compete for their affection. This person realizes that if they want you, they have to go towards you. And this is, you're really just attracting. There is a very content energy about you, very wholesome energy. And there is a lot of love here. And I do see you getting an offer here with this Ace of Cups, a romantic offer, an emotionally fulfilling offer. And I see this person viewing you as a source of peace as well with this Temperance energy. This person really values your feminine traits as well. And they see you as almost magical or ethereal with this energy here. So that's what I'm seeing for you, Virgo. I hope you have a really good day, Virgo. Bye, Virgo.